believe again. Yeah. Amen, somebody. Amen. And that's what God wants us to know today. God shared with me, my brothers and sisters, let me tell you. And I want everybody to be a part, because we just like a football team. Everybody got a part of it.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. Yeah. Everybody got a play to run. Amen. It takes a whole team to make it work.
Yeah.
There's no I in team. We know that, don't we? We're a coach. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
There's no I in team, so it takes everybody to make the vision come to fruition.
Yeah.
Write the vision and make it plain. Read it, let me bring something home real close to it right now, what God has shown unto me. Amen, somebody. And I pray that everybody that is part of this belief and part of this church that would embrace this, I see God doing great things here.
Yes.
God took me to John 14, verse number 12, and he said unto those right before he got ready to leave, he said, ye believe in the work that I do, but greater works than these shall you do. Greater works than Jesus shall we do if you believe in the work that I do. He said, if you don't believe it for my words, say believe it for my works. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
God has called us, my brothers and sisters, to do a greater work in him. Amen.
Amen.
Gotta take some faith.
Yeah.
Yes. I hear the deacon pray all the time that we're supposed to feed the hungry.
Yeah.
Amen. Clothe the naked.
Yeah.
Visit the sick. Amen, somebody. Visit those behind prison walls.
Yeah.
That's the ministry God had called us to do. Because we know it, we were taught even at school, and some of us at home, that action speak loud.
Get
word. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
God had called us in this last day. Not only to see the construction that you see going on, that's part of it. Amen. And sometimes God will give you just enough to build your faith up to take it even to the next level. Amen, somebody. Gave the vision to Deacon Barry. He said, you do it. Then you watch what was in his mind. First he conceived in his thought. Now we see the manifestation, what God has showed unto him. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
And that's what God is showing us, as he can manifest that thought. Amen. That whatever we're supposed to do in him, God will perform it.
Amen.
Y'all hear what I said?
Yes.
Amen. He told the prophet to write it and make it plain. Amen, somebody. See what I was saying unto you. He began to ask his Lord. He answered the Lord, spoke unto him, said, write the vision and make it plain. Don't scribble it. I want everybody to understand. Make it clear what I have for them. Amen.
Yes.
He said, but guess what? The vision is not going to happen tomorrow.
No.
Maybe not even the next day. The vision may not come to pass. He said, the vision is for an appointed time. When people, we want instant gratification. When somebody said it, we want to see it happen right then and there.
Right.
Yeah. Amen. Like,
amen.
And if it doesn't happen right then and there, you better watch it, because people are throwing thinning out on you a little bit.
Amen,
somebody.
Yeah.
Because I want to see it right now. Amen, somebody. Instant gratification. And let me tell you something else. When God has saved somebody, and we want them to change overnight, and in that instant, and in that moment, in a twinkling of an eye, that's not how God operates this thing.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
When somebody receives the Lord, we must give them time to grow.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
We ought not talk about it when we see them struggling as babes in Christ, but we ought to encourage those that we see struggling and just now learning how to walk.
Amen,
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
Because we have to remember there was one time we had to learn to walk.
Amen.
There was one time we was on the wall of sucking milk and not eating meat, but we have to be patient with those.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Patient with them that are struggling and they walk with the Lord. God didn't call me to be a judge.
Come on,
I can't judge anybody. I feel like Paul said, I am the chiefest of sinners and a recipient.
Yeah.
Of God's grace.
Yes.
Right. Got a lot of wrong things. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
Well, you hear me say all the time, but I didn't give up on the journey.
Yeah.
Sometime up.
Yeah.
Sometime down.
Yeah.
And sometime even level with the ground. But I kept getting up.
Yeah.
I had people that were near and dear to me saying, stay down. Quit playing with God. That's what they tell you, because they don't understand. You're playing with God. Won't you just stay out in the church and send encouragement to come on in. Amen, somebody. But we have to be careful when people start their walk in faith. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I'm not talking about, amen, somebody. I'm going to get ready to leave y'all alone, but sometimes I like to tell a little story.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
As I get ready to go to my seat, I'm reminding y'all of a little old lady. Every Sunday, they had church every Sunday, even on Field Sunday. Amen. And every Sunday she had to jump up in church.
Amen.
Amen. And she looked up toward heaven and waved in her hand and said, Lord, I thank you for my new car.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And somebody. But then after service was over, she would walk out the door, down the step, then down the street, to the corner and get on the bus.
Yeah.
And go home. But second Sunday came around and she would back up again and said, Lord, thank you for my new car. Then at the end of service, just like you did on that last Sunday, she would go out the church, down the step, down the street, to the corner and get on the bus.
Uh-huh.
Third Sunday came around, the same old thing, the repetition stuff that she always do. Lord, I thank you, even now, for my new car.
Yeah.
Amen. And she would leave again and go down the step, down the street, to the corner and catch the bus. But one of these Sunday service went a little bit long.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, somebody. The pastor held them a little bit too long. She jumped up and said, Lord, I thank you for my new car. This time she went down the step, down the street, to the corner, and the bus was gone. Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
They decided, she said, well, I guess I'll go back and wait on the next bus.
Mm-hmm.
Found her sitting down on the step of the church house. Pastor being the last one coming out of the church. Walking by, he looked down on her. He said, what are you doing sitting here in the church while everybody is gone? He said, I heard you thanking God for a new car.
Mm-hmm.
He said, maybe you got somebody else riding in your car and you're waiting on them to pick you up.
Mm-hmm.
He said, or maybe you just loaned the car out, or maybe the car is in the shop.
Yeah.
She said, no, brother pastor, let me tell you something. She said, some years ago, I was laying on my sick bed and God came and raised me up from a sick bed.
Yeah.
And I thank him for it.
Yeah.
She said, being I have a child who was in trouble and God showed up and delivered him out of trouble.
Yeah.
She said, but I'm telling you today, she said, I figure if God did all those things, I don't have a car right now, I might as well thank him in advance.
Uh-huh.
And that's what faith really is, when we can thank God before we receive what we ask for.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
And God will deliver it. Amen, somebody. Yeah. Even before you ask for it.
Yeah.
See, that's what true faith is. Some of us want to wait until we receive it from God. But if you really have faith, you start thanking God in advance for what you want.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
In other words, you did. Back then, he could do it now.
Amen,
hey, amen somebody.
Amen.
Y'all, God has brought us to this is black history right here.
Amen.
And black people, if God brought us from cotton sack to Calvary, amen, I believe that same God can lead us on to wherever we need to be.
Amen,
amen somebody. In other words, we're not there yet, but if you keep on believing God, amen somebody, that God will lead us on the way.
Amen.
Y'all believe that today?
Amen.
See, some of us, I want this clear to you. Some of us, we're still staggering from the past, the blow that it has been dealt under us. And some of us still blame the man for the blow that he dealt under.
Mm-hmm.
God says it's time now to walk away from the excuses.
Mm-hmm.
Because once you come to know God and you have to look, we're not there yet to look at what God has brought us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And it's a lot like it used to be, y'all. I've endured even myself, and I'm younger than a lot of people in this room today. And I can see a change. I can see what God has brought us from.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And then I have to believe that God is going to lead us on. Amen.
Amen.
God hasn't done with us yet in this country.
Amen.
God allowed us to come from Africa and different parts of Africa to this country for a reason.
Amen.
We had to be here. There was purpose even in the slavery.
Mm-hmm.
The devil meant it for bad, but God meant it for your good.
Amen. Amen.